Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. At this time, I request respected Naib Amir, Dr. Hamidur Rahman Sahib, to please come and preside in the first opening session.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. I will start the proceeding with the recitation of Holy Quran, and I will request Sayyid Saud Saab to come to the podium for recitation.
The verses I will be reciting before you are from chapter Al-Mu'min, which is chapter number 40, and in its and these verses are from verse 14 to verse 18, and they are in part number 24. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم هو الذي يريكم آياته وينزل لكم من السماء رزقا وما يتذكر إلا من ينيب فادعوا الله مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون رفيع الدرجات ذو العرش يلقي الروح من أمره على من يشاء من عباده لينذر يوم التلاق يوم هم بارزون لا يخفى على الله منهم شيء لمن الملك اليوم لله الواحد القهار اليوم تجزى كل نفس بما كسبت لا ظلم اليوم إن الله سريع الحساب.
جزاكم الله. Now I'll request Naeem Muhammad Saab to come here for the translation of these verses.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. In the name of Allah, the gracious, the merciful. He it is who shows you his signs and sends down provision for you from heaven. But none pays heed save he who turns to Allah. Call ye then upon Allah, devoting your obedience wholly and sincerely to Him, though the disbelievers may be adverse to it. He is of most exalted attributes, Lord of the throne. He sends his word by his command to whomsoever of his servants that he pleases, and he may give warning of the day of meeting. The day of which will all come forth, nothing concerning them will be hidden from Allah. Whose is the kingdom this day? It is Allah's, the One, the Most Supreme. This day will every soul be requited for that which it has earned. No injustice this day. Surely Allah is swift at reckoning.
Jazakumullah. Now request Riyaz Zahid Saab for the poem.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Kalami Paak, Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salam se chand ashar. Kis qadar zahir hai noor, us mabdaul anwar ka. Kis qadar zahir hai noor, us mabdaul anwar ka. Ban raha hai sara alam aina sar ka, ban raha hai sara alam aina sar ka. Chand ko kal de ho gaya, chand ko kal dekh kar main sakht be kal ho gaya, kyunke kuch kuch tha nishan usme jamal yaar ka, kyunke kuch kuch tha nishan usme jamal yaar ka. Us bahare husn ka dil mein hamare josh hai, us bahare husn ka dil mein mat karo kuch zikr humse, turk ya tatar ka. Mat karo kuch zikr humse, turk ya tatar ka. چشمائے خورشید میں موجیں تیری مشہود ہیں چشمائے خورشید میں موجیں مشہود ہیں ہر ستارے میں تماشا ہے تیری چمکار کا ہر ستارے تیری چمکار کا تیری قدرت کا کوئی بھی انتہا پاتا نہیں تیری قدرت کا کوئی بھی انتہا پاتا نہیں کس سے کھل سکتا ہے پیچس اکدائے دشوار کا کس کھل سکتا ہے پیچس اکدائے دشوار کا کس قدر ظاہر ہے نور اس مبدع الانوار کا بن رہا ہے سارا عالم
Jazakum Allah. Now I will ask Nabi Dashar Sahib for the translation of these couplets.
Assalamu alaikum. In the name of Allah, the gracious, the most merciful. Translation of the verses, couplets is recited before us. How manifest is the light of the originator of all the lights. The whole world is becoming as if it were a luminous mirror. After looking at the moon yesternight, I became extremely restless, for there were some signs in it of the charms of the beloved. My heart wells up with passion for the eternal glory of my beloved. Do not talk to me about the fascinations of the Turk or the Tartars. The fountain of the sun manifests the beauty, O Lord, and every star is a symbol of thy splendor. None can find the limits of thy power, who in fact is there to unfold the secrets of this great mystery.
Jazakumullah. Now Dr. Ehsanullah Zafar Sahab, Amir of USA, will be addressing the members through satellite link from the East Coast. We are honored and I will ask Dr. Sahib if he can hear the Jamaat and he can start his address.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir Rahmanir Raheem. MashaAllah, today the sun is really rising from the extreme of the West. And you have certainly highlighted that in the banner which is behind the stage. I'm happy to see all the attendees where Ahmadis have come together to celebrate the occasion. Coming together of Ahmadis, commemorating and repeating the claims of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam, the Messiah and the Mahdi of this age, is a source of great blessing, and you are all privileged by it, and I think the entire USA Jamaat, even those who are not there, would in some ways benefit, you know, from this occasion. I would just like to highlight to you the prophethood of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam. He started off in the earlier years of his mission by referring to himself as a muhaddis and a mujaddid, and our Lahori Ahmadi friends are still stuck in that. But he moved on to the last 7 or 8 years of his mission, where he clearly stated that he is a prophet, he is a Nabi, he is a subordinate Nabi to Hazrat Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that he is a Nabi, he is a prophet. And that brings a tremendous weight to the things that he has spoken, written, and asked us to focus on. When we look at his claims, he has a claim of being a very humble man, which is a fact, not desirous of the embellishments of this life, lived very, very simply as a practical matter throughout. We see, mashallah, his progeny is prospering all over, but we must remember that this promise of the promised son and of the blessings of on his children and his they're growing from one to ikse hazar hove, maula ke yaar hove, all of these things, they are a gift from Allah. These are not something that he went out asking for. This was prophesied by Rasulullah sallam. This is something which is given to us as a gift by Allah, and by us I mean the entire Jamaat. I also want to emphasize that the issue of him being the owner of the house in which everybody is safe is a very important thing. All of you being Ahmadis are gaining that safety. And in this day and age, that is a tremendous, tremendous benefit, and we ought to thank Allah for that. The other thing that we see is that his teachings are, and his pronouncements are, of the status of a wahi, of a revelation, in the Quranic sense. In the Quran, where a wahi is given, it is not a fleeting thing. It's not an idea which comes and then sinks or disappears somewhere. It doesn't work that way. And I would submit that the simple example is the revelation to the honeybee. And the Quran elaborates that, how Allah sent a wahi to the honeybee to do such and such. And that honeybee is still following that. We don't know for how long. And I don't know, I can't say as to how long it'll keep on doing it, but just gives you the weight and the depth of the meaning of wahi when Allah makes it that way. So when we look at what the wahi is to Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam, look at what happened with the issue of jihad. He has pronounced with great clarity that the jihad of the sword is prohibited in this age. Now, our brother Muslims, they tried to penalize him for that. Not that they did, but they tried to. They have raised their voices against us as his followers. However, it took 100 years, but now they are all in our camp. And things that we were saying as a part of the teachings of Masih Maud alayhi salam, they are now professing them themselves and holding them up all over the world, at least in the West they are. So we need to look at teachings of Masih Maud alayhi salam and apply them to our own lives as well as pronounce them to the world around us. It seems that the issue of jihad crystallized around the attacks of 10 years ago here in the United States and then elsewhere. And everybody's focus on that was on that, and the public at large was receptive to it. And we need to look around and see what are the things which can now be of interest to the population in the United States and the West, because this is where our message is to be sent at the moment. This is where the sun is rising in the West, and you are proclaiming that in that banner behind Dr. Rahman Sahib as well. So let's keep that in mind, that the West at this time is possessed with the issue of Sharia. They are blowing it up in all kind of different ways, and they are doing it because our brethren, they are practicing the Sharia in a primitive fashion. I don't think they are practicing real Sharia. These are inventions that they have added on to the practice of Islam. And as followers of Masih Maud alayhi salam, perhaps this is the time to pick that up as a subject and bring it out and illustrate also separation of the mosque and church, which is crucial going forward, and which really is the example that Rasulullah Sallam set up when he was in Medina. His was a secular government in Medina. Notwithstanding whatever came afterwards over the centuries and in different places, we can't really vouch for it. But the model that he left us with was a secular government with me. So we should ponder on these things and see how we can elaborate the material and bring it home to our countrymen here in the United States. That's where our focus needs to be, not on the international scene as much. And let Allah open the doors for us by His own choice and by His own help. Do remember that Masih Maud alayhi salam had a special regard to where Ahmadis come together and then practice the teachings of Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salam. Responsibilities are individual, but real blessings come when we do collectively. So please think in terms of working together as a Jamaat, as a team or teams, and seek the blessings of Allah which He has designated for the Messiah of this age, Mirza Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani alayhi salam. In closing, I hope and I pray that we will be all deserving of the prayer which Allah has taught us in the Quran. Rabbana atmim lana nurana waghfir lana innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir. We all have certain potentials. We all carry a certain nur, a light. However, how far we take it is in large part dependent somewhat on our own efforts and our own understandings, but really and truly on the maghfirat of Allah Ta'ala and Allah Ta'ala's qudrat. So let's hope and pray that, and I join you in that, that we all benefit that way. Assalamu alaikum, and I hope you will have a very successful jalsa.
Jazakumullah, Amir Sahab, for your time, and I'll request you to please lead us in prayers.
All right. Let's join in silent prayer and pray for Allah's blessings, all the things that He promised Masih Maud al-Islam, that when people come for a jalsa, he talked about the annual jalsa, but really applies to any jalsa. And we beg His mercy and His grace that He grant us all those blessings individually to everybody, to take care of the difficulties anyone is in, to open doors for all of us, each one of us and all of us. And may He be pleased with our effort, and may we be deserving of His grace and mercy. Please join me. Ameen.
Ameen. Jazakumullah.
Rafiq.
Wa alaikum salam. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu amma ba'du fa'uzu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Respected brothers and sisters, honorable guests of the Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. I'm very thankful to Almighty Allah for providing the opportunity to welcome you all once again to the 26th West Coast Jalsa Salana at Baitul Hamid Mosque, Chino. Alhamdulillah, hundreds of people are here both from far away and from hereby. I would like to welcome all those who have traveled a long way for the sake of attending this Jalsa Salana, because their presence as the guests of the Promised Messiah Salatu Aslam makes this Jalsa a very special and a blessed one. Inshallah Ta'ala, some of the members will be joining us tomorrow. One of them is Naseem Mehdi Sahib, who is a missionary in charge, and also our Naib Amir Munim Neem Sahib. They couldn't make it. Inshallah, they will be here tomorrow. Naib Amara, Dr. Naseem Ahmadullah Sahib, Dr. Zaheer Baja Sahib are with us, and also many national AMLA members are with us in this gathering. Dr. Wajib Bajwa Sahab, who is Sadr Majlis Ansarullah, he is here to attend the Jalsa. And also, I would like to welcome Sadr Lajna Maila USA sister, Saleh Malak Sahiba. I will also take this opportunity to welcome Chaudhry Munir Sahab, who was the first missionary at Baitul Hamid Mosque, and he took a lot of pains and worked hard for this mosque when the mosque was built. We are very thankful for this opportunity to hold the second USA Jalsa Salana here, so that the West Coast members who can't go attend the Jalsa Salana at the Washington, they can partake of the blessings of the Jalsa Salana. In addition, we are blessed that this Jalsa closely follows the dates of the first Jalsa Salana that was instituted by Hazrat Masih Maud al-Islam in Qadian in 1891. It is probably the only time that the two jalsa takes place simultaneously in the opposite ends of the earth. These two jalsas, and in fact every jalsa anywhere in the world, shares a common goal to fulfill the objectives laid down by Hazrat Masih Maud Salat Waslam when he began this institution. Let me remind you of this purpose of the Jalsa Salana in his own words. Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam writes that the primary purpose of this convention is to enable every sincere individual to personally experience religious benefits. They may enhance their knowledge, and due to their being blessed and enabled by Allah, they exalted their perception of Allah may progress. Among its secondary benefits is that this congregational meeting together will promote mutual introduction among all brothers, and it will strengthen the fraternal ties within this community. Stressing the importance of the event, he also declared, "It is therefore essential that all who can afford the journey join this conference, which will be filled with many considerations of expense and undertaking this sacred journey for the sake of Allah and His Apostle." Hazur said, "I repeat that the conference should not be treated like an ordinary worldly conference. It is an event based solely on the support of the true faith and propagation of the religion of Islam. The foundation stone of the community has been laid down by Almighty Allah Himself. He has prepared nations to join to it in the near future. This has been done by the one who is all powerful. Nothing is impossible for him." Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam explained that such a gathering should be held for the following reasons: so that the Jalsa would provide points of spiritual wisdom, which are essential for the increase in faith and the true recognition of Allah. So that the believers may increase in knowledge of their faith. So that members of the community should cultivate such a change in themselves that their hearts are ever inclined towards the hereafter, and the fear of Allah takes root in their hearts, and they become a model of piety, righteousness, sympathy and tenderness. So that the members should increase in brotherhood and gain an enthusiasm for showing humility and hospitality. So that the members may spend time in the company of righteous. So that the members who have newly joined the community will be able to meet their brothers and will thus establish ties of brotherhood and mutual recognition. So that good plans for the propagation of the faith in Europe and America can be made. So that the mutual bickering and aloofness among the members can be removed. So that the members who have departed from this temporary abode will be remembered in prayers. With these objectives in mind, let us make this Jalsa a real oasis of peace in these turbulent times. This is a special occasion to promote love and brotherhood among each other, and to promote the tradition of greetings with each other with the Islamic salutation of Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. I urge all the participants of the Jalsa to greet one another, whether they know each other or not. This will create the atmosphere of a truly Islamic society. The Islamic greeting is an excellent way to spread peace and love. Also, it would be great favor and blessing if those who have stopped talking to one another due to some disagreements end their conflict and forgive each other and become reunited in the bond of brotherhood. One of the objectives mentioned by Hazrat Masih Maud Alaihi Salatu Wasalam is to show humility and hospitality at the Jalsa Salana. Hospitality is a courtesy that is mentioned in the Holy Quran, and one that has always been the custom of the prophets of God and their followers. It is a mean to develop mutual love, as well as to make impression on the others and bring them closer, and thus open way of tabligh. We are aware of the excellent model of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam of honoring the guest, as well as now that Hazrat Masih Maud Salatu Wassalam also paid great attention to this aspect. Allah Ta'ala had informed Prophet Masih Salatu Wassalam that the people would come to him in their droves, and when people come to a strange place, they are considered as a guest. He thus received the revelation many times from Allah Ta'ala that the people would come to him in their multitudes, and that he should not be annoyed nor tire of meeting them. Therefore, as the host Jamaat, we should remember that if we do not exhibit courtesy and high morals, we could incur Allah's displeasure. Hazrat Masih Maud Salatu Wassalam initiated these jalsas for the enhancement of spirituality and religion. It is therefore the obligation of each volunteer to serve the guest in every way possible. These are the guests of Hazrat Masih Maud Salatu Wassalam, and we too are commanded not to tire in serving them. I humbly request every brother and sisters, young and old, to spend these 3 days in contemplation and prayers. The recitation of Durood Sharif to greet each and every member of the Jamaat with love in their hearts, and to serve and to be the service to each other, and to overlook the shortcomings of others. Before I conclude, let us remember another important objective of the Jalsa Salana, that is to remember and pray for all those who are no longer with us. This year we have lost many of our members, both young and old. We mourn their passing and pray for Allah Ta'ala to have mercy on their souls. Let every one of us who is attending this Jalsa to increase our love for Allah Ta'ala and to make a sincere effort to improve ourselves, so that we truly become the community that Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has desired us. Let us pay attention to our own tarbiyat and the tarbiyat of our children, and follow the guidance of the Holy Quran and the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in our homes and in every aspect of our lives. This jalsa is a great opportunity for us to practice and improve our own behavior and qualities, and in this way train our children. We must teach our children the importance of this annual gathering, because in the future the responsibility of maintaining this institution will fall on them. I would like to conclude with the prayers of Hazrat Masih Maud Salatu Wassalam for the participants of this jalsa. Hazur writes and prays, "May Allah Ta'ala be with those who undertake this journey solely for the sake of Him. May He reward them abundantly. May He have mercy on them and relieve them of their pains and miseries and anxieties. May Allah fulfill their noble desires, and may He raise them on the Day of Judgment in the company and His servants who have attained His grace and mercy. May He safeguard them throughout the journey. O Allah, O You with abundant grace and bounty, O Merciful, accept all these prayers and grant us victory over the opponents with glorious signs. Verily, Thou hast all power and strength. Amen."